Yeah, what we're going to be cooking today is yassa. It's one of my favorite meals. I make this for my mom and someone else.
Oh.
Yeah, because it's a lot cheaper than takeaway. So that's why I like romance, it's cheap. Basically, it's my favorite dish, and it comes from the Senegal, my people, Senegalese. Yeah, they're my people, innit? And it consists, obviously, of very sour flavors. It's really nice. It's a dish you have to leave to marinate overnight. So it's something that is very very popular with people from other countries whenever they come over to Senegal. Like, you know, all those tourists that come over and walk around naked and take pictures of stuff, and Africans are like, oh, look at those idiots. Yeah, those people really like yassa, as well as the native people of Africa. So this is something you really should try. I mean, if you've had your jerk chicken or curry chicken, you ain't had nothing till you've tried chicken yassa. It's beautiful, it's delicious, so we should have to do it. For this, you will need citrus juice of some form, mainly lime or lemon. Now, the science behind this is, in Africa, they have like really tough chicken, and there's acid in this, you know, like acid. And it burns down and it softens up the chicken. So some people would cut fresh ones, but to me that's long. This is realistic cooking, and nobody chops up lemons in their house. So yeah, this is lemon juice. You can also use lime. You will need, to combat that taste, you're going to need brown sugar. Yeah, I use brown sugar because it tastes nicer. You can use whatever kind of sugar, but I always dry it brown with everything I use. Yeah, that will combat the sourness of that. You'll need dijon mustard. I don't have any left. I use all of it for that. You're gonna need olives. Yeah, pitted olives, no chilies in them or anything like that. Just olives. You're gonna need a lot of onions because that's the base of the sauce, right? Now, for those of you who don't know what onions look like outside a burger, this is an onion. Mandem, this is an onion. You cut this and put it into food. It makes it taste nice. This is garlic. Garlic as well. I know a lot of people have not seen garlic, they're scared of the kitchen. And we've got seasonings, so this is adobo. Yeah, you can use Maggi seasoning as well. I know some of you might use OXO, you can use Maggi, no, whatever's your choice. And of course, what Nigerian food is complete without a little bit of that pepper powder? But be careful how much of you use, because if you use too much of it, you might end up... Now, one of the main ingredients in this meal is Dijon mustard, French mustard, as the French call it in Senegal. And you know, the great Bob Marley once said,
the more you accept herbs, the more you accept Rastafari.
But round here we say,
the more you accept Dijon,
the more you accept yassa.
So as you know, this is a chicken dish. We did all the mixing last night, then we let it marinate overnight. Little, you know, juices, permeate, little osmosis, you know. So here we go. Unwrap that. Like a teenager on prom night. And then this is what it looks like in the morning. You guys see that? You see that? That beautiful. The juices all swimming around, the chicken is underneath, we got the onions, we got it all spiced up, the Dijon mustard is what gives it that kind of yellowy, kind of thick covering, that kind of saucy covering. The olives are in there, the onions are chopped up into like thick rings, because you're going to need to separate the onions from the chicken at some point later on, and when we show you what we're doing. We use like 7 onions in here. This is like serious. Because the onions, they themselves, they have all the juices inside them. So once you start cooking, sometimes what happens with the yassa is it gets very dry. So you need the juices.
What we're gonna do is we're gonna brown the chicken. Now I'll need something to put the brown chicken in. We're gonna brown it and then I'm gonna put it in the oven, you know, because on that night, let's just like to avoid all salmonella thing, because salmonella is not cool. Though it's a brilliant way to lose weight, food poisoning. But its side effects may include death. What we do is we separate the chicken from the onions and the marinade. We put it in the pan and we let it brown. It's not really to cook it, just, you know, give it that brown texture. We're back now. Most of the chicken's brown. So what I'm going to do is, this is a mixture of the sauce, the onions, the olives and all that, the little marinade that we made. As you can see, I cut them all into rings, so it's easy to move off the chicken, because if you dice, it's really hard. And it makes it for a more interesting and authentically African, at least the way it's done in Senegal anyway. It's very oniony. You're supposed to be able to see the onions. The onions aren't actually supposed to dissolve. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to sieve out most of the juice. Yeah, I'm going to save the juice for later while it's cooking. Because what we're going to do is we're going to actually fry the onions, and then we're going to stick the chicken in the oven and let it cook in there. And then later we'll do a little medley of everything. Squeeze that. Get all the juice back into the container. Try and put in the onions and olives. Make them as fluid free as possible. And into the pan. We're basically gonna saute this for the next, 20 minutes while we are
hungry.
Yeah, well, sometimes you have to suffer. Yeah, so this is gonna cook down, and we're gonna grill our chicken, oven cook our chicken, whatever the English word for it is. We've had the oven heated now at 200 degrees. So it's a bit warm in there. I wouldn't stick my head in there if I were you. Except, of course, if you're a BNP member, then go ahead. Need tans anyway. So, putting the chicken out onto a little tray. Got foil on it, for obvious reasons. Put as much chicken as you can, but don't put all of it, obviously, if you don't have a big enough tray. And yeah, we put them into the tanning booth, innit? Those of you here from... those of you watching this video in Essex know all about this, don't you? Yeah, that's right. See how tan they look? But they're not actually cooked, they're just fried to seal flavour in them. So yeah, I'll be back in a bit. Got some chicken in there, so I'm just gonna slide the remainder all in. Oh, this is hot, man.
As things you tend to just can't be out of
the oven, yes, logically. Who would have thought? And now remember that I saved up some of the juices from earlier. So where it comes in handy, basically I'm just going to pour it in into the pot. Yeah. So there's a lot of flavour trapped in there. I didn't want to put it in earlier because it would mess up the whole frying of the onions, and also eventually to dry up if you put it in from the beginning. And you don't want your yassa. I mean, some people like it dry, but personally I like to have a little bit of sauce to it, because we're going to eat it with rice. And now I've got a little special trick with doing the rest. I'll show you guys later. But yeah, mix it. Yep, well there you have it. Yassa. And my rice. Got my own funky way of doing my rice, but yeah.
We're not trained cooks, we just come to the cook. So Nick and Chef, go put some clothes on. Gordon Ramsay, go F1 and stuff.
Enjoy. Hope you found the video easy. Please leave comments and send requests as well. We'd like to hear your feedback.